Hey guys, welcome back to my kitchen. In today's video, we are making egusi soup. Egusi soup is one of the simplest soup to make and is a Nigerian soup. When you have the right recipes, it's one of the simplest soup to make. So let's get right into it.
Please, if you are yet to subscribe to my channel, please do so by hitting the subscribe button. I will also turn on the notification bell to be notified of any video I post.
The ingredients we are using for the soup. So this is egusi, blended egusi. Although this one I blended with my crayfish, that's why it has this color. So these are melon seeds, also known as egusi. This is how it looks like when it's not blended. For the protein, we'll be using some beef, some goat's meat, some cow skin, so a dried fish. I already deboned the fish. Only washed and deboned. So I have some blended, it's called bonnet peppers here, blended pepper. These are chopped onions for seasoning the meat. So this is cooking salt to season the meat as well. These are all-purpose seasoning. These are seasoning cubes. This is dry thyme to season the meat as well. So this is fermented locust beans, also known as iru. So these are palm oil. For the vegetables, we'll be using bitter leaf, thoroughly washed bitter leaves, and some ugu leaves, also known as pumpkin leaf. First off, we'll be seasoning our meat. So I'm adding the all-purpose seasoning. I'll add the chopped onions. I'll add some dry thyme and some seasoning cubes. Please note that I'm boiling the beef first before the goat meat because the beef is tougher than the goat meat. So after I boil the beef for like a few minutes, I'll now add the goat meat to continue the cooking before we go into the preparation of the soup proper.
First thing, you put your meat on the fire, try to steam for a little while. Then it will leave its own stock, its own water, before we add our water to it. Just cover it and allow it to steam for 2 minutes. You can see, I'll make it boil and so we'll just add water to it now.
So after adding water, I'll cover it and allow it to cook for 10 minutes before we add our goat meat to it. So while our meat is cooking, we'll add some water to the egusi to make a paste. While our meat is cooking, in another pot, we'll pour in some palm oil. So after adding the oil, we'll start cutting in our egusi. So while that is frying, we'll add our goat meat to our beef. Next, we'll be adding some water to it now, while we'll cover it and allow it to cook. After adding the water, we'll cover it and allow it to come to a boil. My goosey has been boiling for a little while now. We'll just add some blended pepper to it. You can see egusi has been boiling now for 15 minutes, so it's now time for us to add other ingredients to it. See how it looks. See how lumpy it looks. We're going to introduce our meat and other ingredients now. For the egusi to be properly cooked. For the soup to be ready. I just added a beef to it. Next, I'll be adding my meat stock. At this point, I'll test to see if I'm adding more seasoning to it, any seasoning or salt. It's okay, no need to add any more seasoning or salt to it. So let me add other ingredients. So. Next, I'll be adding our cow skin. Next, I'll be adding our fermented locust beans or iru. This is completely optional. If you don't like the smell or aroma of it, you can skip it. Or if you don't like seeing it in your soup, you can blend it also. But add a very unique aroma to the soup. Next, I'll be adding the dry fish to the soup. At this point, just be careful how you stir it so that all the fish will not just dry. You need to see some of the fish when you are done cooking the soup. Let's allow it for a few minutes, like 2 minutes, before we'll come back and add our vegetables to it. First one I'll be adding is our bitter leaf because it's tougher than the pumpkin leaf or the ubi leaf. So I'll add my bitter leaf first. Note that the bitter leaf has been thoroughly washed. Just cover it. I will come back and add our ubi to it or the pumpkin leaf to it. Now I'll be adding my pumpkin leaf. At this point, I would like to add a little oil to it, palm oil to it, so you can see that the oil is no longer obvious in it. I want it to be shining. Just allow the ubi to cook for a little while because the ubi cooks fast. You see our soup is ready now. Next, we'll be dishing it and pairing it with eba or garri. That's what we're pairing today's soup with. Next, we'll be dishing our soup. Also, this is the end product of our egusi soup. We're pairing it together. Feel free to use any salt of your choice. The aroma is everywhere, so it's looking so yummy and very attractive. Please, if you are yet to subscribe to my channel, please do so by hitting the subscribe button. And also turn on the notification bell to be notified of any video I post. Thanks for watching.